السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. Welcome my brothers and sisters in Islam. Today's fourth lesson about the Sunnah, implementing the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم during the day and night. We have one book, as we said, 1,000 sunnah per day and night. And we are up to sunnah of Adhan, the sunnah for the Adhan. In Islam, we have for obligation salawat, we have six Adhan. طبعاً, if there is rain or if there is, for example, like the time is not secure, then the muadhin will not say hayya ala salah. He would say, there's different riwayat. Some of them, sallu fi buyutikum or sallu fi rihalikum, pray at your house or at your place. This is in case of there's rain or there is, like, for example, like disease, or the time is not secure, the fear of time. Okay, inshallah, the book is available online if you want to, inshallah, if you have it. Okay, for the muadhin, it is recommended for the muadhin to have wudu. It's not like condition, but it's recommended for the muadhin to have wudu, also for the muadhin to face the qibla when make the adhan, also for the muadhin to be seen by outside. For example, if you have masjid, then people who are outside of the masjid, they could see the muadhin. Okay, also for the muadhin to put the two fingers in the ears while making adhan, and hayya ala salah, go to the right, then hayya ala falah, you know. This is also the sunnah for the muadhin. For people who hear the adhan, it is sunnah for them to say exactly same as the muadhin. If the muadhin says Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, he would say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Okay. Only hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah. The people who hear the adhan would say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That's for the sunnah to say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. حيّا. طبعا another some scholar said if you are at the masjid to say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. If you are outside of the masjid to say it is also sunnah to say exactly same as the muadhin. Okay, but if you are inside the masjid, then to say hayya ala salah. So la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Also, one of the ruling of the adhan, if you are at the masjid and the adhan started, then it is not recommended, it's makruh, disliked by the sharia, to leave the masjid and go outside. Only if you want to go to another masjid. Okay, for example, if you are at the masjid, then the adhan started, then you want to go home or go somewhere, this is not recommended. But if you want to go to other masjid, that's it's okay. But generally, it is important, any sunnah, to stay if the adhan started. Also for the adhan, let's say like many ruling about the adhan, subhanAllah, and the sharia. For example, for salat al-fajr, if the adhan, for example, let's say 5:15 and iqama 5:45, for our sisters in Islam, do they have to wait or they can pray immediately? Obviously, they are allowed to pray immediately after the adhan started. They pray the sunnah, then they pray the fajr salah. They don't have to wait for the iqama. Iqama only if someone wants to pray at the masjid. Okay. Also, it is sunnah to say, وَأَنَا أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّهِ وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَسُولًا. Okay, number three, after the adhan, طبعاً sending prayers to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, it is not part of the adhan. It is not part of the adhan, but it is recommended for the muadhin, the person who makes the adhan, and everyone to say, as to send salah prayers to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After the muadhin finishes the adhan to call for prayer, you should ask Allah's blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the best supplication which can be said in this regard is the الصلوات الإبراهيمية. الصلوات الإبراهيمية. التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات. السلام عليك أيها النبي. Okay. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد. الصلوات الإبراهيمية. This is the sunnah. Or if you can, just say اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. But As-Salawat Ibrahimiyya is more perfect. It's better. Okay, after As-Salawat Ibrahimiyya, also to, sunnah to say this dua. And this dua, if you keep making this dua consistently, then bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will have the shafa'a of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The intercession from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma rabba hadhihi da'wati tammah was salati al-qa'imah ati Muhammadan al-wasilata wal-fadilah wab'athhu maqaman mahmoodan alladhi wa'adtah. O Allah, Lord of this perfect call and established prayer, grant Muhammad the intercession and favor, and raised him to the honor station to be honored. You have promised him maqaman mahmoodan alladhi wa'adtah. If you make this dua frequently, then you will be granted bi-idhnillah azza wa jal the shafa'a of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Taba'an, the shafa'a, Prophet Muhammad or the angels, or the Quran, or some righteous person. But for the shafa'a, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to allow it. It's not like, example, like if I promise someone to have shafa'a, like I cannot do it. Like no one can, you know, promise with the shafa'a. Only if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows the shafa'a. Arbita an المشفوع والإذن للشافع, to give permission to the person who does the شفاعه, and to be pleased with the person who is going to have the شفاعه. طبعا after the شفاعه, يعني سبحان الله, Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave us so many things if we commit a sin in the dunya and in the akhirah, to the, for this sin to be wiped out, to be removed. Like for example, if you repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, the sin will be wiped out. If you follow it by doing good deeds, the sin will be wiped out. If someone make dua for you, Allahumma ghafir lahu, Allahumma rahmah, make dua for you, also the sin could be like wiped out. Or even subhanAllah, if you didn't do all these three, but you have subhanAllah like taste from Allah Azza wa Jal, difficulty, calamity from Allah Azza wa Jal, and you have patience, also the sin will be wiped out. Then in the grave, when like at the grave, at the waiting for the hour to come, subhanAllah, all this like wipe out the sin. If not, then the shafa'a of Prophet Muhammad sallam, or the angel, or the Quran. If not, then the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if the sin is still with you, like all after all these things, if the sin is still with you, then subhanallah, even the shafa'at did not remove the sin, for example, the sin, after that, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the mercy did not remove the sin, still the sin with the person, then only blame yourself. Don't blame anyone else. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us so many things for our sins to be wiped out. Okay. Number five, finally, you can ask Allah the Almighty anything for yourself and ask the grace of Allah Azza wa Jal, because your supplication will be answered this time. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, repeat the words of the Muadzin, and when you finish, ask Allah what you want and you will get it. Bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The author, jazakallahu khaira, he said, the sunan in this adhan, 25 sunnah. Subhanallah. Taban, if you have any question or anything to say, please mention in the comments. Assalamu alaikum, Ibrahim, and sahlan, and Asma Adil, mashallah. Bi-idhnillah, we continue. For the iqama, okay, we have in the Sharia, sometimes we have in the Sharia, for example, dua for opening the salah. We have more than one dua. And the scholars said the wisdom behind this, Allah Azza wa Jal knows the best, but they said the wisdom for the, we have example like more than one dua for opening the salah, not to be routine, to be subhanAllah, one time we say this dua, other time we say other dua. Okay, for iqama also they are like different madhahib, and the iqama it's not like one fixed, that's it. Sometimes you could say, like for example, like similar to the adhan, and that's Allahu alam with the Hanafi madhab. Okay, inshallah. Okay, for the iqama, generally the iqama is shorter than salah. And also iqama is faster than the salah, not same as the salah, the iqama, so the adhan, but faster. Okay, the author jazakallahu khaira said, turning toward the qibla, Kaaba direction, when making the adhan and iqama. When you make adhan and iqama, face the qibla. B, standing up. Okay, stand up while making adhan or iqama. Taban, if someone, a traveler, okay, for example, we are like, let's say like 30 people and we are a traveler, then the adhan of dhuhr started, we make one adhan and we make iqama for individual salah. Okay, if we are a traveler, we make one adhan for dhuhr, then we make iqama for dhuhr, after that we make iqama for asr. We don't make like two adhans. Also, if we want to pray Dhuhr and Asr at Asr time, also one adhan and iqama for each salah. Okay. Okay. B, as we say, standing up. C, making ablution to have wudu. Okay. Refrain from speaking between the time of adhan and iqama. And between adhan and iqama, sometimes the adhan muadhin like take long time. حي على الصلاة Then he could talk to someone else and continue. حي على الصلاة It is sunnah not to talk between the adhan and the iqama. Keeping stability during the iqama. Emphasizing on the A and H in the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, Allahu, yeah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Okay, some people they have like some mistakes in example, some of them say Allahu Akbar. It's not a question. Is it Allahu Akbar? Is Allah greater? It is like statement. Allah is the greatest. Okay, Allahu Akbar. Also not Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Then putting fingers on the ears when making adhan, that's also the sunnah. Extending and raising the voice when making adhan, but lowering it when making the iqama. Okay, the adhan is for people inside the masjid and outside the masjid. Iqama only for people who are inside the masjid. طبعاً some masajid in Muslim countries, both of them are outside. Okay, both of them, the adhan and iqama, they use the microphone for both. But generally the iqama, يعني it should be only for the, like inside, like for people who are inside. Okay, separating between the adhan and iqama, the separation can take place by praying two rak'ah. طبعاً adhan and iqama, sometimes the adhan could be like late, and they pray adhan, they say the adhan straight away than the iqama. It is sunnah to separate between the adhan and iqama, maybe at least to praying two rak'ah, or making one sujood, or saying the dua after the adhan. Okay, but not like so quick. Okay. Inshallah. The one who hears the adhan or iqama is recommended to repeat the same word except when the hearing qad qamat as-salah, qad qamat as-salah, the prayer is established. He should say la hawla wala la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. Okay, for قد قامت الصلاة to say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There is no might or no power except by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Okay, بإذن الله. If you have any question, أهلا رجاء. بإذن الله. Okay, next one is praying to a sutra. Praying behind a sutra. What is sutra? When we pray, we put something in front of us. Okay, when we pray, we put something in front of us, then people who want to walk, they can walk after or behind the sutra. The distance between you and the sutra, some ahadith mentioned like three arms, between the place of sujood and the sutra, it is away like the width that the sheep can go through, can walk through. Maybe for example, like could be like half meter. Okay, between your sujood and the sutra. Sutra and your sujood, there's like distance. Okay. طبعاً subhanAllah, this sunnah, subhanAllah, forgotten, wallah. Many people not implementing this sunnah. Even if they are able, but subhanAllah not implementing the sunnah. The Prophet Muhammad, he said, if you want to pray, then stand behind a sutra. Come close to it and don't allow anyone to pass between you and the sutra. Okay, do you need to put sutra even if you are alone? Example, if you are in the room, and the room are locked, only you are at the room, do you still need sutra? The answer is yes, because also the sutra for the shaitan. Okay, subhanAllah, this the prophetic tradition stipulated putting the sutra when performing the prayer, whether in the masjid or in home, for men and women. Some Muslims don't pray behind sutra, therefore they deprive themselves from the reward of applying this sunnah. طبعاً sutra could be chair, could be anything, something, but cannot be lying. Has to be something, you know, raised up. This sunnah is repeated several times by the Muslim during the night and day when he performs the regular prophetic prayers. Al-Duha prayer, morning prayer, masjid entry prayer, witr prayer, and the last prayer at night, the obligatory prayer, by the woman when she prays alone at home. However, when praying at masjid, the sutra of the imam is enough for all who pray behind him. So the imam who has sutra, everyone behind the imam, they don't have to put sutra, because the imam is like sutra of the imam will be enough for everyone behind the imam. Okay. Sutra is anything put in the front of the one who prays, such as wall, stick, column, etc. In respective of the width of the sutra. Okay, the width doesn't matter, but has to be like something. Okay, the height of the sutra is open is one span approximately. And for example, it could be like shibr bil arabi sami. Okay, one shibr, one span approximately. The distance between the legs and the sutra is three arms. Distance sufficient for making the prostration. The sutra is to be used by imam and individuals, whether in the obligatory or subhanallah, the other salah, the recommended salah. Okay, the sutra of the imam is enough for all persons, all people praying behind him. Therefore, it is allowed to pass in front of the praying person when necessary. For example, sometimes at Taraweeh, or someone needs to leave. Okay, then the imam, after finishing the salah, start with another salah. Okay, like two rak'ah, then start again. There's someone already leaving, and mashallah, so many lines, and to go out of the masjid, subhanallah, like this distance. Because they are praying behind the imam, it is okay to walk in between the lines. And this one does not affect their salawat, their salah. Okay, it is okay. If needed, it is okay to walk between lines if there is imam. The benefit of praying this sunnah, it prevents from interrupting prayer by the passers-by. Because subhanAllah, if you don't have sutra, if you pray like in the middle of the masjid, people walk in front of you, behind you, like, you know, subhanAllah, like, it makes like less concentration. But if you have sutra, then you will be focused. It helps avoiding looking here and there, because when the Muslim uses the sutra, he will only look on one space, on his space, and will think more in the meaning of the prayer. Because you have sutra, you cannot go further. Only the sutra, and it is sunnah to look when you are standing, generally, except in tashahud, to look at the place of the sujood. Only in tashahud, you look at your finger. But generally, all the like time of the salah, to look at the place of the sujood. Also, it can help others in passing by without any need to walk in front of one who prays. Because you have sutra, okay, then they can walk. For example, if you are late and you have sutra, you know, people can walk in front of you or want to pray sunnah also, inshallah. Okay, next one, bi-idhnillah, tomorrow. Yeah, we continue, inshallah, tomorrow. Or the other sunan, bi-idhnillah azza wa jalla. Okay, Marid al-Zahaimer, Zahaimer. Don't know what's called in English, Zahaimer. The person who forgets. Taban, okay, we have fidya, we have kafara. Fidya different than kafara. Okay, fidya, if someone, for example, sick and will not be able to fast anymore. For example, someone is 70 or 80 and sick. In this case, he has to give for each day fidya. Like, you know, for example, is to feed one person per day. Okay, kafara, that's, for example, if someone made an oath and could not feed 10 people or clothe 10 people or free a slave, then we move to kafaratu siyam, which is to expiate, okay, by doing the fasting, which is 3 days. Only if we are not able to do the three options. Okay, about the fasting Ramadan, it's called fidyah, fidyatu siyam, okay? Fidyatun min siyamin, okay. For this disease general, specifically, Allahu alam, it depends. People are not one level. If someone is still like having like mind and he is or she is like sane, then yes. But for example, if someone lost the brain and that's it, like he always like forget, he's not, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed from him or her the obligation of fasting. Like example, someone, that's it, like he lost or she lost their brain, they are insane now, then they don't have to fast, and they don't have to give the fidyah. But Allahu alam, with zamahi, zahaymar, I think they should give fidyah, Allahu alam. Because it comes and goes. Allah, if like always like this, that's different. If always forgetting, that's different. But if sometimes, yes, they have to. Inshallah. Jazakumullah khayra. If you have any questions, inshallah, bi'idhnillah, just post bi'idhnillah. I will try to answer bi'idhnillah azza wa jalla. Tomorrow we're going to start the sunan or praying at the sunnah salah. Because there are like many types of sunnah. Witr, al-duha, and dal, subhanallah, many rulings. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله خيرا for attending and listening. May Allah عز وجل reward all of us بإذن الله.